you need to decide first between you and your wife if you have if you are married.
Okay.
Kung talagang gusto nyo. Because
hello, fellow fellows. It's Sunday evening here in Werribee, in west of Melbourne, and I'm spending coffee time with one of my friends here in Melbourne, Gilly. He used to live in Korea, South Korea.
Yeah, South Korea.
Sansa, South Korea.
In
Goje
City.
That's
south of Busan.
South of Busan. Yeah. And how long have you been here dito sa Melbourne?
Almost 2 years.
Okay.
Almost 2 years.
Paano yung naging path mo from, you know, from where you were to here?
Yeah, we applied from South Korea.
Mm-hmm.
As a skilled migrant.
Yes.
Skilled migrant. Because I'm an engineer there. In South Korea, in a shipbuilding company.
Mm-hmm.
First is Daewoo Shipbuilding, and the second one is Samsung Heavy Industries.
Okay.
So from there, we applied. Permanent resident, going here to Australia.
Yes.
Yeah. So that's our pathway.
And right now you are already permanent resident,
yeah, permanent
right?
Resident.
Permanent resident.
Yeah.
And so, 2 years, how has your experience been, Gilly, dito sa Australia? As far as yung culture, yung differences, you know. Mm. Start with the culture. Ano yung primerong nakita mo na difference dito sa nakagisnan mo?
I think the culture, I have not seen any big difference.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So you're talking about yung sa South Korea at saka dito?
Sa South Korea, I think there's a difference because South Koreans, I think for examples of work, in South Korea, they spend, I think, more hours in work.
Okay.
They work normally there 10 hours to 12 hours.
Ah, alright. So, yeah, very very industrious.
Yeah, like Japanese.
Okay.
And the boss, when you come, for example, in the office, nadudu na siya. If the working hour is 8 a.m., normally yung mga boss, supervisor, manager mo, normally nadudu na sila before 7.
Wow.
Nadudu na sa office.
Talagang
tapos mag-stay sila kung 8 to 5 ang working hours, yeah. Mag-stay sila hanggang minsan 7 or 8 ng gabi.
I see.
Yeah. So talaga ano sila sa work. Napaka dedicated. Tsaka yung meron silang hierarchy. Pagbago ka, for example, in the company, ang tawag nila doon, shinipsawan, ibig sabihin new employee.
New employee
sa Korea. So, parang ikaw yung utusan lagi, magtimpla ng
okay.
Something or bibili. For example, meron kayong may birthday sa group or sa team nyo.
Mm-hmm.
So, bibili ka, for example. Pero ano yun, yung pagbili ng ano, yung money, parang merong budget. Pero ang normally gumagawa ng mga services, pagbili ng mga cake or something, ice cream. Yung bagong employee.
So, talaga, utusan kung utusan.
Hierarchy. Tapos, syempre, laging may respect sa mga
nakakataas.
Dito, tsaka yung meron silang word na ginagamit to respect, for example, yung mentor mo or something. Dito kasi, parang name lang, okay na eh.
Yeah.
Tawagin mo yung manager mo.
By first name, Arthur.
Yeah, ganun. Pero yun yung mga difference.
I see.
Sa work, sa community.
So,
sa community, I think parang kasi ano sila eh, Asian din eh. So more parang yung culture same sa atin sa Pilipinas.
Mm-hmm.
More. more similar.
More family, family community.
Community. Parang yung katulad, for example, isang ano doon, na hindi ko makita dito sa Australia, yung boss mo parang may time na parang nagiging ano yung turing niya parang anak sa'yo.
Ah, okay. Yeah. I see. So parang nagiging, parang, nagkakaroon ng other than a business relationship.
Business, parang family. Family yung minsan yung treats niya sa'yo. Minsan pag, for example, I experience sa dinner, yung tipo na pagkakain, parang gusto ko niya subuan.
Ganun ka-close.
Tapos pag-iinom kayo, for example, kasi sila mahilig sila sa alcohol talaga eh.
Right.
So sa atin, di ba, parang yung mga dati, nagtatagay ng yep. alcohol, so palitan kayo. Tatagayan ka niya, tapos for
the same glass.
So yun yung mga ano.
Pero dito sa Melbourne, sa Australia, hindi. Talagang business.
Yun yung isang difference na napansin ko. Pag yung work lang, parang hindi nila tinatanong more on your personal family side ng ano mo, life mo.
Alright. Now, I know na you have a wife and two kids.
Yeah.
Alright. Kamusta naman yung kanilang transition from living in one country to this country? Was there a difficulty sa on your part or on the family?
I think because we're living we live in South Korea for sila yung my family maybe 7 years.
Okay.
For me almost 9 years. So hindi na ganun kahirap yung transition. So we already adjusted maybe away from our close family in the Philippines. Right. So naka-adjust na kami minsan. So we're four, so minsan talagang apat lang. Tapos new place, parang kung ano gagawin or something.
Okay.
So, pag sa school, I think si Gideon and Faith, my kids, ang naging ano nila adjustment nila talaga sa school, kasi si Gideon was in the home school for 2 years sa South Korea. So yun yung naging ano niya, I think. So biggest from, adjustment
from home school, from public school,
so marami may mga classmates,
May interaction.
So I think that's the one the biggest difference for him.
Okay.
Nag-move kami dito sa Australia.
Now, my question is, you know, follow-up question along that line. Para sa mga nagbabalak na mag-migrate from the Philippines or anywhere else in the world to here, ano yung primerong advice na may bibigay mo sa kanila?
I think you need to decide first between you and your wife if you are married.
Okay.
Kung talagang gusto nyo. Because 2011, I already know how to migrate in Australia. Through my friends, they settled in New South Wales in Dubbo or Dubbo. Dubbo.
New South Wales.
So they migrated 2011. So during that time, when they came here, I messaged him through Messenger, Facebook Messenger, to know what's the process. So I already know during that time, but I think I'm not really that decided. Firmly decided.
Okay.
Because of the circumstances, maybe because of the money.
Yeah.
Kasi during that time, nagbabay kami ng bahay in the Philippines.
Right.
So wala talaga kaming pera to process kasi you need money to process the something IELTS.
Yep.
The IELTS
the requirements for
requirements the visa. For the visa and also for the visa itself, the payment for the visa. But I think during that time it's lower compared now. So it's really really expensive.
Okay.
But I think the first one is you need to talk together.
As husband and wife,
also maybe if your kids
if they understand already.
Yeah. I think that's the first thing.
Now, in terms of finances, since you touched up on paying for visa, did you require a migrant, a consultant to assist you, or was it have, you know, on your own?
It's our own, yeah, because okay. You already know during the time 2011 I have already idea how to migrate. There's some general requirements and some general steps. And then one of my friend also from South Korea is in Queensland now. He applied first, maybe around one year before us.
I see.
And then he was approved also from South Korea as yes. PR. Same company before, but my another company when I was resigned, he stayed in the company that and then I transferred to another company.
I see.
But he applied 1 year before, so nagtanong ako sa kanya. So tanong ano yung mga process, so alam ko na kagad. So sabi niya, sometimes you don't need the agency or consultant.
I see. Yep.
Because all of the things that you need is already in the website. Yeah, in online.
Imi.gov.au.
Yeah, and then there are forums.
Yep.
In online that you can ask questions to know what mga questions ka, di ba? Parang doon ako madalas na merong group doon minsan based on the month ng application mo.
Yes.
So, iyon yung ano, yung naging parang malaking support. Kung ano yung mga questions mo about migration or mga skill assessment. Mm-hmm. Tsaka yung ano pa ba? Sa migration, I think also the Pinasay is big factor also.
Okay.
Kasi
you have to be ready.
Good thing during that time you can pay through credit card. I think now it's still can pay
the same way. Okay.
So sometimes because you don't have the cash, you can pay through credit card.
Right.
I think I paid credit card for the IELTS IELTS and the skill assessment in my profession.
Yep.
And also for the visa because they only accept, I think, credit card.
Mm. But everything was yung step by step you went through it, never asking
consultant
or sa agency.
I think kasi ano, para to lessen the expenses, the cost. But
now,
but if you have the money, it's better to have the agency. Yeah, if you really have the money.
Okay.
So to make your work lesser because they already know. So you don't need to study.
You don't need to study
the process. It's also a process, so maraming requirements.
Okay.
At mahirap ano, nasa South Korea ko, so mga requirements kailangan ko sa Pilipinas. So I always ask my father na for example the NBI, the NBI pwede siya magpadala.
Ah, okay.
But the good thing, they only need the scan copy.
Ah, right.
Scan copy through, so ini-email niya lang yung mga document.
All right. And finally, before we go, I understand na meron kang sarili mong blog that you're setting up and it's focused on managing your finance. Anong pangalan ng blog na ito?
It's I set up the blog to 2010.
Okay.
LearnFinancialEducation.com.
Okay. So that's www.financialeducation.com. So that's one whole name.
Basically, it's majority of maybe 90% of the posts about finances.
Okay.
Saving.
General idea on how to manage your finances.
Sometimes I post something about our experience about the traveling, something like that.
That's good.
Because it's also personal blog.
All right. Okay. Yeah. So be sure to check that out, fellow fellows. www.learnfinancialeducation.com.
And then I have one more.
You have one more?
We're updating it with my son.
Mm-hmm.
It's all about Australia.
Okay.
So I think if you're planning to migrate, there's a one page there about our experience, my experience on how to migrate.
Right.
It's a long one.
Okay.
I think it's more than 5,000 words.
All right, and it will give our fellow fellows an idea.
Idea.
What your experiences was. Basic, in migrating.
The basic steps.
Ang pangalan ay
forkangaroos.com.
Forkangaroos. The number four or
the number four. F-O-U-R.
The number four. Forkangaroos.com. So be sure to check that out, fellow fellows.
Yeah.
And I want to thank Gilly for visiting us dito sa ating kapihan. Dito sa Werribee. Hopefully, may na-pick up kayo na information about migrating, what life is like here in Australia. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and comment down below for more updates regarding our future episodes. All right. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Brother Gilly.
Bye.
All right. See you. Bye.